Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here. Welcome back to our Battle Brothers Peasant Militia campaign. We had to split up this episode into multiple parts, so let's cut straight into the action. Some raiders somewhere to the north. Many brigand raiders and some brigand marksmen. Okay. Engage. Didn't have any issues. They get shields. Nothing crazy for armor. Well, that pickaxe is a level 2 pickaxe. That's an arming sword. I don't know if that's a level 2 there. Okay. We're gonna have to close with them quickly because they're not gonna close with us. They do have a bill hook. Is that a throwing spear? Yes, that's. Those are throwing spears. Okay. Okay. Okay, that's exactly what I wanted. Ow! That isn't. It's a bill hook. Okay, good. Because I could take this guy and pound on him. I'd like to get behind here and deal with that, but... he'll die if I put him here. Because the archers. It's not the smartest idea, but we're gonna do it. Forces the archers to aim here. Ooh, ouch. Damn, he's dead. To get up here into this. I think he's dead. Maybe. It's hard to tell. These archers are dangerous and I can't fight through this line like this. Ouch. And it doesn't help that you're not hitting anything right there. Thank you. Yeah, we kind of knew he was dead. Okay. Ooh, okay, we're good. Wow, what hits? What? Oh, he was behind here. He was right here. I was like, how can he bypass that? Makes sense now. Really? Please don't kill him. You gotta be kidding me. What a shot there. We cannot hit him. Thank you. We saved him. The cut purse is traumatized and broken nose. Oh, that might be it for him. His resolve is always bad. Engelbert died and Omar. Not what I thought. Not what I had in mind there, by any means. Yeah, because what is his resolve now? Jeez. I mean, I think it, wow. I think that'll be it with him as a soldier. It's very unfortunate. But we just hired him. That makes sense. We did lose two other brothers. Cover. Take Brawny. adrenaline. I want Pathfinder. Dietmar, quick mind. Good one there. Yeah, I think that means cut purse is one is done. Rally the troops. Does he not have rallied the troops? Does. So it must be when next one. Like the next day. Three skull, terrified villagers. Company renown. We gained the sergeant's sash. You were unsure at first about signing Rimwin to this important task, where he was committed to revelry and carousing as any other man. But Rimwin takes to his duties with zeal that is first admirable and later worrying. Buffing down at the rising hour of the cowardly and infirm, Raymond decides that everyone must start the day much earlier. He runs the men through the usual sparring routines and checks their equipment for splits and wear, but to do such light work, he adds strict rules about setting up and breaking camp, formation drills, lessons on flanking, forced marches with stones in their packs, and a detailed punishment regimen for anyone who dares to fall behind. Such words as backbreaking, cool, flint-hearted, merciless, as well as dozens of other saltier epithets ring in the air whenever Raymond is safely out of earshot, though never when he is sleeping. For the brothers have learned that Raymond, the sergeant, truly never sleeps. This day will help us greatly. This will help us. It will. But where's my sergeant's stash? There it is. Resolve. Okay, so here's the retinue. Like this. Scavenger would be nice. So the recruiter is the one we're kind of going after. What is this? The ghosts. Some time to think about this. Bodies. I'm going to dismiss Raymond, probably, depending on how these brothers look. Survivor, okay. Brave. Bleeder. He's hesitant. How about that? Melee defense? He could be good. Okay, so let's just repair that for right now. Bro. You're gonna be field bow, bro. Okay, bill hook. Spear right now. Okay, so you'll have this. You have better bows now. 40 and 60. That's why they were doing so much damage to me. Jeez. Billhook's got to go on someone. Gonna go on him. I would like them on the flank like this, actually. Do I have another reach weapon? I do. Let's put him in that. Him in that. Reach. Reach. You're throwing. Okay. Five, you're throwing, okay. Five, 25. Give him this. That's 90. 90, that's 90. Can't let our sergeant die, obviously. Okay. So we don't 40 to 60 on that. This 40 to 70. Yeah, this one's better. That's much better. We need bags and belts with them. Okay. Same thing with like him. All right. So let's. Pair. Bear comes to you, rubbing the back of his neck, nervously pulling up his shirt. He goes into town with a handful of goods. Okay. Okay, we earn some crowds. Sigur gets resolved and gets euphoric. Hands Sigur the crowns and off he goes. A few hours later, the peddler comes running up with a small lockbox in hand. A wily grin on his face, undeniable, and he's unwillingly fist pumping as he glides to you. When he tries to speak, gasp of breath sees him. You hold your hand out, telling him to take his time settling down. The man hands over a heavy purse of coins, saying that it is your cut of the profits. Before you can even say anything, the man wheels on his head and jumps away. Okay. Alright, so in case we have any issues at this point, I haven't done a save, so let's do a hard save. You get the jump on the grave robbers, drawing swords, they slam the shovels down to the earth. So we got grave robbers here. So the next episode, we will go ahead and jump into this one. So thank you all for joining me. Don't forget to hit that like below, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. Later.